Hello, and welcome. In this video, we will provide an overview of the recurrent neural network model. A recurrent neural network, or RNN for short, is a great tool for modeling sequential data. The RNN only has one layer, but it maintains a state, or a context, in order to remember the analysis that it's done up to that point. This state recurs back into the net with each new input, which is where the net gets its name. Let's take a closer look at how this works. Input data first flows into the model's single layer. The data is processed in the same way as a traditional net, but as we mentioned, the net also receives the current state or the context along with the input. If this is the first data point, then some form of initial state is used, which will differ depending on the type of data being analyzed. After processing, the data is output with a new context that represents the most recent point. Then this context is fed back into the net with the next data point, and so on. We repeat these steps until all the data is processed. Keep in mind that since the context changes at every step, the net can produce a different output for the same input depending on the current state. This is what allows a recurrent net to perform sequential data processing. Recurrent neural networks are extremely versatile and are used in a wide range of applications that deal with sequential data. One of these applications is image captioning. Although it's not purely recurrent, Andre Karpathy and Li Feifei created a model that's capable of understanding the elements in an image. The model can assign words to the elements and string them together to form a caption that describes the scene. You can take a look at two examples of that here. Another application for recurrent nets is music composition. A network can be trained using MIDI files, which are a type of standard for digital audio. After learning about rhythm and melodic patterns, the net can output data that can be converted back to the MIDI file format and listened to. We only covered a few applications, but variants of the recurrent model are continuing to solve increasingly complex problems. You can see a few of those variants here, but they're beyond the scope of this video. Despite all its strengths, the recurrent neural network is not a perfect model. One issue is that the network needs to keep track of the states at any given time. There could be many units of data, or many time steps, so this becomes computationally expensive. One compromise is to only store a portion of the recent states in a time window. Another issue is that recurrent neural networks are extremely sensitive to changes in their parameters. As a result, gradient descent optimizers may struggle to train the net. The net may suffer from the vanishing gradient problem, where the gradient drops to nearly zero and training slows to a halt. It may also suffer from the exploding gradient, where the gradient grows exponentially off to infinity. In either case, the model's capacity to learn will be diminished. By now, you should have a good understanding of the main ideas behind the recurrent neural network model. Thank you for watching this video.